with the brake caliper off. We can use some water pump pliers to take the dust cap off. Side cutters to take the cotter pin out. Oh my gosh, it's only finger tight. Yeah, that's how it works. Carefully take the hole. I'm going to take out the wheel bearing and the washer. I'm going to put the nut back on. Boink! The other bearing and the dust seal come off the backside. With the rotor on the workbench, we can also lay out everything in order of appearance. So you remember how it goes back together, the cap, the nut, the washer, the small bearing. This is where the rotor would go. Then we have the rear bearing, which is usually large, and the dust seal, which we will replace. It didn't leave the cotter pin in here because I chucked them, and I always get a new cotter pin every time. Next thing you want to do, we're going to clean out all the grease out of here and then repack the bearings. To cut this rotor on the brake lathe, we need to find the right bearing support that fits on this side, which looks like that one, and on this side, which looks like this one. So this bearing support slips on, the rotor slips on, the other support slips on, and you find whatever the spacer fits. Put the crazy nut this side out, and it's backwards thread, looks like this. Just give it a snug. When we cut this, there might be some vibration, which will cause a bit of chatter and give you a really crappy finish. So we've got this rubber band with lead weights on it, which we just hook together through the center, and that absorbs any vibrations. Again, to avoid chatter, we want to put the cutter as close into this arm as we can. If it sticks out too far, it'll start chattering and give you a really crappy finish. When we're satisfied that it is perfectly located on the machine and we haven't got it sitting crooked, then we can go ahead and make one nice light cut, little degree increments on here. I tend to do about 3 lines on here just for a cleanup cut. Make sure you cut off of both sides. If you just cut one side, you'll actually flex the rotor and end up with a tapered rotor. So even if you're taking a baby fart cut off of one side just to support it, you have to cut both sides at the same time. Cranking it all the way in. Now I give it about 3 lines on the lathe. Got a lever down here to make it go. This is the lever. Pull. And it starts feeding by itself automatically. Now you go do something else while it's cutting. Don't stand here watching the machine. Work on the other side of the car. Wheel bearings will get cleaned in solvent. You want to wear rubber gloves. You want to wear eye protection. This stuff is not good for you. You just get in there, give it lots of solvent, and flush all the grease out. You want it as clean as you possibly can. No grease, no dirt, no nothing. If there's any discoloration on the wheel bearing, you're going to want to have new bearings, because they don't get better, they just get badder. That's kind of cool. So now we're going to clean everything with soap and water to wash all the solvent out. The solvent will thin out the grease or keep the grease out of the bearing. We don't want this. We want this to be just absolute gorgeous clean metal. So clean you could lick it and just taste metal. Kind of like sucking on a Hot Wheels car when you're a kid. We want it to be nice like that. Scrub it nice and clean, rinse it out with water, and blow it all dry. Tempting though it may be to blow it this way and have it spin at Mach freaking 8, you've just spun the bearing. Ooh, a zillion times faster than it was designed to go, with no oil. Worse than that, there's no outer race keeping the ball bearings inside, so you're hoping that they stay in there, and as you spin it a zillion miles an hour, these may fly out and hit you in the face. When we got a sweet finish on both sides, it's time to take this rotor off and pack the bearings. Remember when your kid brother's eating a peanut butter and jam sandwich? And they take a big bite in the peanut butter jam sandwich, and the jam and peanut butter oozes out between their teeth, and you're like, ew. That's what we want to do. Kind of cup the grease in your hand like this, with your fingers through here, and just pack it through until the jam's oozing out from between the bearings. Ew. Do that all the way around. do one last quick thorough clean of the inside of the hub, and then we're going to take our beautiful grease gun and we're going to pack this hub full of grease so that it is flush with grease from inner bearing race to outer bearing race. And then we can put the bearings in and call it a day. Okay, here's a basic drawing of the brake rotor and hub assembly. Over here we got the dust seal to keep all the dirt and everything outside of the bearings and hub. We got the rear bearing, which is usually big, the front bearing, which is usually small. Over here we'd have the washer and a big castellated nut holding the thing together. Inside here we want to pack it full of grease from this point to that point, full of grease. The reason for that is when you're driving down the road and everything's nice and hot and juicy, all of the grease inside here might want to get warm and liquidy and slide out or run out of the bearing and fill up the hub. If there's nowhere for it to go because this is full of grease, then when it cools down, we still have grease near the bearings, so we want to keep that nice and full. And always use a new dust seal, because, ew. I like to put a little bit of grease on the seal so that it's not going to get damaged when I install it. This one has a flange on it, so the flange goes on from the outside. Usually a little block of wood and a hammer will tap it in place just fine. Ta-da! Once we have the hub on with a new bearing, we're going to put the washer on, put the rounded side facing out, line up the key, castellated nut, we're going to screw it on like so. We spin the hub and tighten that nut good and tight. This seats the bearing. Then you're going to back it off, and then you're going to tighten this as tight as you can with your fingers and put a new cotter pin in. Some people bend this thing around the nut. I bend it around this way, and I cut the end off with a pair of side cutters like so. Right in the eye. The dust cap can go on with some gentle taps of the hammer. This one's been beaten all to heck because it's 37 years old and it just gets damaged. So I actually reshaped it with a ball peen on the inside on a piece of wood to get it back to a decent shape so it doesn't get gouged by that. Just set it nicely in there. Some just nice gentle taps. And just make sure it's seated all the way around. Put a little bit of Never Seize on the caliper pins, bolts, because you want to be nice to the next guy. Sometimes that next guy is me. As with every fastener that you do up, you make sure it threads in by hand before you even think about putting a wrench onto it. Because if you cross-thread your spindles, you're going to be a sad panda. These ones use a hex bit, 3/8, and we do them up nice and tight, like a tiger. Oh my gosh. The world is going to be a happy place. Let's put the wheels on and do a smoke show.